Amy, you think that you can escape me. You have travel abroad. You are married. You have children. You have a good job. All these good things for you. While nobody else in your family has succeeded in life? Because of the curse we have made in your family. But you break that law. I will make your life a real misery. I will destroy you.
My love, it's a bit late. And I am tired. I have to go to bed.
Okay, my love. Have a good night. I will follow you soon.
Amy, I am here. You thefts that you have escaped me. Distance is not a problem for us sorcerers. Now I am making incantation on you. You will fall sick. I put trouble in your marital life and in your job. Be cursed.
What, are you still here at home? Don't you go to work today?
Oh. Why are you slap me? Why are you behaving like that, suddenly?
Just go. I don't want to see you here again.
I don't know why my husband is behaving like that. This is very strange. He has never slapped me since we are married. I don't know what is happening.
Colleague, the boss is calling you. He wants you to come very urgently.
Oh. Really? I am coming. Sir, you asked to see me?
Yes, Amy. But it's not a good news. Yes. We have suddenly have a big loss in the enterprise. Many contracts that we had with the federal government has been cancelled. And now we are obliged to lay some people out. So you are the first employee that lost her job today. I am sorry. You will see the secretary to give you your letter of dismissal. So from today you're no longer an employee of the enterprise.
Oh my god. What is happening to me suddenly?
We won't. I promised you before that, I will make your life a real misery. You will lose everything. You already have lost your job. The next thing is your husband that you will lose.
So why are you crying?
I lost my job today. The manager said the enterprise lost many contracts. And that he have sent back some employees. But I realized that I am the only one employee that have been dismissal.
It's surely because you are not performant. It's why is only you that has been dismissal.
Oh my husband. Please, you are not supportive. At all. You make me be more sad.
Oh Lord. Thank you for this revelation. So Sister Amy is in great trouble. I need to go see her to see what to do.
Oh, who is coming? I am not waiting, somebody. Oh, pastor. How are you?
I am fine, sister. And you? How are you?
Not too good, pastor.
In fact, the Lord told me that you are in big troubles. So I came to know what's going on with you.
This is what happened to me, pastor.
Oh, my dear sister, that is very serious. Do you have a prayer life here?
Not really, pastor. We only pray when we eat to bless the food.
Oh, this is not a Christian life. As you know, you have succeeded in life. And your family, you are the only person with a good situation. And you know that there are many sorcerers in your family. The devil came to steal, destroy and kill. So you have to protect what you have in the blood of Jesus and prayer. I think that you're under heavy spiritual attack.
So what can I do, pastor?
Do you know midnight prayer? Have you ever did it?
No, pastor.
Midnight is a time of transition. It is a time when we move from one day to another, and what you need to know about midnight is that many activities take place in the spiritual realm at this time. In Acts chapter 16, verse 25, the Bible says, "And at midnight Paul and Silas prayed and sang hymns to God, and the prisoners heard them. And suddenly there was a great earthquake, so that the foundations of the prison were shaken, and immediately all the doors were opened, and every man's bands were loosed. Exodus 11, verse 4, the Bible says, "And Moses said, Thus saith the Lord, About midnight will I go out into the midst of Egypt. Here therefore the Lord God Almighty waited until midnight to execute judgment upon Egypt." David is another example. In Psalm 119, verse 62, "At midnight I will rise to give thanks to you because of your righteous judgments." The man after God's own heart says, "At midnight I will rise to give thanks because of your righteous judgments." Matthew 25, verse 6 says, "And at midnight there was a cry, Behold, the bridegroom comes, going out to meet her." So you see there's a significance about the midnight hour. The Bible says in 2 Chronicles chapter 1 verse 7, "That night God appeared to Solomon and said to him, Ask whatever I will give you." Notice that it was at night that the transaction took place between Solomon and God. And if we read 1 Thessalonians 5 verse 5, "5 ye are all children of the light, and children of the day, we are not of the night, nor of darkness." When you read these scriptures, you really must ask the Holy Spirit to open your eyes to discernment. Because if there is one reason why you need to pray hard before you go to bed, it is because we need God to watch over us. We need God to protect us. When you fall asleep, you are in your weakest state. It is at night that most people are vulnerable to spiritual attack. And it is also at night that the greatest victories are won. We see this in the case of Jacob, who had wrestled with someone all night. Genesis 32 verses 23-33, "And he arose at night, and took his two wives, and their maids, and his 11 sons, and crossed the ford of the Jacob. And after he had brought them across the torrent, and had brought over all that he had, Jacob was left alone. Then a man wrestled with him until daybreak. When he saw that he could not overcome Jacob, he struck him in the hip joint, and it dislocated while he was wrestling with him. Then he said to Jacob, Let me go, for day is breaking. But Jacob answered, I will not let you go until you bless me. What is your name? The man asked. Jacob, he answered. From now on, replied the other, you will no longer be called Jacob but Israel, because you have wrestled with God and with men and you have conquered. So we understand that the real battles and the real ones were fought during the night. The day is only the reflection of what happened during the night. The Bible advises us to sleep less. 1 Thessalonians 5 verse 6, "Let us not therefore sleep, as others do, but let us watch and be sober." We must understand that the forces of darkness do exactly that. They operate in the darkness, both spiritually and physically, in the natural world as well. The devil is cunning and he does not play fair. He will wait until you have let your guard down. When you are asleep and defenseless, that is when he will attack. But today, we are going to pray that the Lord Almighty will protect us.
Oh, Pastor.
You have to pray for supernatural covering so that God can block any attack from the enemy. Refuse to have bad dreams and nightmares. Lift up your faith and believe that God can deliver you. Refuse to feel sleep paralysis. Refuse spiritual attacks. Take 3 days of fasting. And during these fasting, make midnight prayers.
Amen, Pastor. Thank you very much.
You're welcome, my sister.
Heavenly Father, in the quiet of this hour, we come before your throne with humble hearts and open minds, ready for renewal. We acknowledge your sovereignty and greatness, and we thank you for the privilege of fellowshipping with you in prayer. We ask for your mercy upon us. Even now, we invite your Holy Spirit to dwell among us, to guide our thoughts and words as we seek your divine presence, protection, healing, guidance, and wisdom. O Lord, as we prepare to rest our weary bodies, we ask for your divine protection while we sleep. Surround us with your angels, who excel in strength and vigilance. Protect our minds from disturbing dreams and our bodies from all forms of harm. Send us your peace. Let your peace be our blanket, covering us with serenity and tranquility throughout the night. May we awaken refreshed and renewed in love, ready to face the new day with faith and courage. Merciful God, as we sleep, we pray that you will grant us divine guidance through visions and dreams. Speak to us deep within our subconscious mind. Do not be far from us, we pray, but let your wisdom, insights and revelations bring us into the light of your truth. Open our spiritual eyes to see and understand the mysteries of your kingdom. Help us to discern the meaning and significance of the messages you convey to us, even in the realm of dreams. Empower us to apply your divine wisdom in our waking moments, so that we may walk in alignment with your perfect will. Precious Lord, we continue to pray for healing, both physical and emotional. Pour out your healing power upon those who are sick and suffering. May your touch bring restoration, rejuvenation, and complete recovery. Heal the brokenhearted, Lord, and heal their wounds. Replace their sorrow with joy and their despair with hope. Let your peace flow like a river into their lives, refreshing and renewing their body, soul, and spirit. Even now, Lord Jesus, we invite you into our presence, your Holy Spirit, to fill us with your wisdom and divine understanding. Teach us your ways and grant us discernment to make wise decisions. Enlighten our minds with your truth, so that we may walk in the path of righteousness. Guide us in our relationships, our careers, and all aspects of our lives. May your gentle way be the compass that guides us on the right path, protecting us from deception and evil. Help us to surrender our will to yours and trust in your perfect plan. Lord, we also seek your intervention and guidance for the day ahead. Order our steps and align our hearts with your purposes. Lead us to the people, places, and opportunities that will advance your kingdom on earth. Grant us divine encounters and divine appointments, that we may be vessels of your love, grace, and truth. Heavenly Father, I pray that you watch over me while I sleep. I ask that you keep me safe, Jesus. Defend me from every attack of the enemy. Protect me from all the troubles that can be found in the middle of the night. Just as Paul and Celeste worshipped in their darkest hours, I too will sing your praises. I sing that you are holy. I say, bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me, bless his holy name. I will continue to lift your name on high, Jesus. Higher than all my worries and problems. Higher than all principalities and powers of darkness. As the book of Psalms says in chapter 57, I pray that you will be merciful to me, O God. For my soul trusts in you. And in the shadow of your wings I take refuge until the calamities have passed. I call upon God the Most High, God who does everything for me. He will save me. I will sleep peacefully knowing that you have said in your word that I should not be afraid, for you are with me.
She has started to pray. I think that we have to attack her, to discourage her, and avoid her to become more stronger, and to be able to destroy our yoke on her.
Yes, Matter. I will do it. Stop what you are doing. If not, I will destroy you completely. Stop that prayer.
What a dream. I will not be discouraged. I will continue. I must not be discouraged, for you, Jehovah, are my God. It is you, the Creator of all ages, who will strengthen me. You, the only one with the power of resurrection, are going to help me. And so I speak with the authority that is in the name of Jesus. I will not have bad dreams or nightmares. I will not encounter spiritual attacks while I sleep in the name of Jesus. Instead, Lord, I pray that you will give me a sound mind, peaceful and relaxing rest. I come before your throne, God, with a heart that is after yours and a mind focused on you. Keep me in your arms tonight, Lord Jesus. I put all my trust in you, Lord. All my convictions about every situation I face, every battle I face, all my trust is in you. I trust that you will guide and order my steps. I pray that you will give me an ear that is sensitive to your instruction and direction. Give me eyes that will always see your goodness, and I pray for a heart that will always remain faithful to you. Lord Jesus, you are the solid foundation upon which my life has been built. You are the Son of the living God who died on the cross for my sins, and your blood was shed for me, so that I would never be defeated as your child. That is why I have complete faith and trust in your power, for even death was powerless to hold you in the grave. And when you watch over me, I know the enemy is powerless over my life. You are my resurrected Savior who has the power to resurrect every dead thing. And so today, I receive your resurrection power and declare that there is nothing dead in my life.
She has won the fight. She is persevere in prayer. She won us. There is fire everywhere.
My love, I am deeply sorry for what I did to you. I behave very hard against. Forgive me for that.
I forgive you, my husband. I knew that you were under bad influence. See, God bless you. Oh, who is calling? It's my boss. Yes, boss, I am listening to you.
Amy, I am happy to inform you that, by unexpected miracle, everything has back to normal again. The cancelled contract has been given to us again by the federal government. So, I offer you a new position. A manager position. With many advantages. Your salary will be double also. So you are welcome to start tomorrow.
Oh, thank you very much, my God. Thank you for this great victory. I will always praise you, my Redeemer. Brothers and sisters, this is the end of this video. Please like and tell us in the commentary your testimonies about midnight prayers. God bless you.